I have feelings I don't understand. I have thoughts, desires, I can't control them. I find myself doing things that I'm ashamed of. Unspeakable things. And yet I continue to do them again and again. But you can't blame me. It's not my fault. I can't help it. Sister Mary, she did it to me. And all I can do is wait for it to happen again. Father, please forgive me for what I will do.
Full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. In the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen.
Everything's ready. Well, how was it?
Good kid, huh?
Hey, Marie, how was your date with Joey?
Good kid like his old man, yeah? Bet you two had a swell time.
No.
No what?
No, he's not a good kid. And no, I didn't have a good time.
Yeah?
Yeah.
Where'd you two go?
To a hockey game.
Oh, yeah? Who won?
Papa, I don't even know who played.
Marie, I just don't know what I'm gonna do with you. You gotta be more open-minded, you know? Geez, you ain't never gonna catch a husband like this.
I don't wanna catch a husband.
No, I guess not. Tell me, Angel, what do you want?
I know what I don't want.
Waiting for your Prince Charming, is that it?
Maybe.
Father Thomas, will you hear my confession? The sin of pride. I'm 26 years old. My parents tell me that I'm going to be an old maid. I am so lonely. And so very frightened. And angry.
Are you angry with God?
Yes, Father. For not helping me. I want to be loved.
God loves your soul.
But my body. My flesh.
Excuse me. I have an appointment with Mr. Stern.
Your name, please?
John McPherson.
Oh, yes. Please, go right in.
Thank you.
Mr. Berner?
Thank you, Marie.
Pleasure seeing you
Thank
again.
You very much, Henry.
And I'll have that information for sure by Tuesday.
Okay. Thank you.
I'll walk you to the elevator.
Yours truly, Henry Stern. And that will be all, Marie. Marie.
Yes, Mr. Stern?
You've been with me quite a while now. 5 years, is that right?
You know, I've never pried into your personal life.
Yes.
But there's something I've just got to ask you. How is it none of these smart young men have grabbed you up? I mean, my God, what's wrong with these young men? Forgive me, Marie. I'm very sorry. I've just got a big mouth.
It's all right, Mr. Stern. You mean well. There was someone a few years ago. It just didn't work out.
Marie? Henry told me your name. Would you have lunch with me?
Yes.
I guess that's the first time I
saw it.
So when my father got sick, I had to quit college and take a job to help out. It was supposed to be temporary. But time passed and I never went back to school. You know how it is. You think you're going to do something in the future, but you keep putting it off and making excuses. And before you know it, it's as if your whole life has slipped away from you. And you have been sitting here listening to me all afternoon as I go on and on about myself. You've hardly said a word. What do I know about you?
What would you like to know?
Everything.
All right. Have dinner with me tomorrow night, and I'll tell you everything about myself. But I must warn you. I can be a terrible bore.
I don't believe that for a minute.
Jogging of yours every morning, you have more time for your old man.
Papa.
Well, it don't look nice. You prancing around Brooklyn in your pajamas.
I have told you 1,000 times it isn't my pajamas. I have a right to my own time, even if I do still live with you and Mama.
If you was married, well, I mean, imagine telling your husband to get his own coffee because you're prancing around in your pajamas at 6 in the morning. I mean, oh, jeez.
Okay, who started it? I'll be home late.
Yeah?
Yeah. Got a date, Angel?
Mm-hmm. With who?
A man.
Congratulations. Is he Catholic?
Mm-hmm.
Well, what does he do?
He's an antique book dealer.
A what? Is that a living?
I gotta go.
Hey! You look nice. Take it easy, will you?
Everything was just perfect until the accident.
What accident?
My father was a hunter. He was on the trail one morning, tracking a deer, and he must have stumbled and tripped. The gun went off and killed him. A stupid accident, really. My mother was crushed. After that, she spent all of her time locked upstairs in her room, mourning for him. And she became very ill, and Sister Mary came.
A nun?
Yes. She was a friend of the family. She took care of us for a while, but it's futile, really. My mother's health began to fail, and slowly her life just faded away. She was gone, too. And I was left with Sister Mary.
Where is Sister Mary now?
I'm sorry. What was that?
Sister Mary.
Oh, she's gone, too. But you're here now. Sister Mary.
Thank you.
You're going so fast.
Hey, baby, take it easy.
What are you thinking about?
You.
And what do you think?
How afraid I am of you. It's been 4 perfect weeks. And I'm afraid.
Why?
I'm afraid of getting hurt, and I'm afraid of losing you.
Marry me. You love it. It's a beautiful old mansion. Used to be the family retreat. Well, used to go up there, my mother. Father, Sister Mary. It is a paradise. No noise, no people around bothering us. Just a fine old house surrounded by beautiful countryside.
John, where is Sister Mary?
Dad.
Oh, John.
Oh, excuse me. Yes, hello. Oh, Richard, how are you? A first edition, are you sure? Just hold on. Marie. This is going to take a few minutes. Yes, go on.
Tell me this, Richard. Is he willing to sell? Yes. I see. All right, I understand. Listen, I must have that book. Absolutely must have it. I've been looking for it for years. Yes, it's true. My mother owned it once, but she had to sell it.
Sounds fantastic. Yes, of course I'm interested.
Sorry, John, I was curious.
I apologize. I should have told you there's just one thing that I'm very touchy about.
I don't like others in my library, even you, my love.
Scared, huh?
I guess.
What? Come on. You can tell your old man.
I am scared.
Listen. I ever tell you what happened right before me and your mama got married? Boy, that was really something. Day before the wedding, she calls me up and she tells me she gotta talk to me. I says, what's wrong? She says, nothing. Finally, she tells me she got scared. Scared of what, I said. Scared that she might be making a mistake. That maybe we don't know each other good enough to get married.
What happened?
You're here, ain't you?
I love John. I can't believe it's really happening to me. Getting married.
Hey, that's only natural. If you wasn't scared, I'd be worried. Jeez, marriage ain't to be taken lightly. It's for keeps.
You like John, don't you?
Sure, what's not to like? Hey, he ain't exactly the kind of guy I'd go bowling with, but hell, I ain't married him, you are. And you love him, yeah?
Yeah.
Seems sort of big for the two of us already.
It does.
Hey. What? What I just thought of.
What?
Babies. Before you know, we're gonna be grandparents. Wow. Our little girl's gonna be a mama just like you.
Tony.
Everything's gonna be just fine. Marie's gonna be a merry woman. And that's what we wanted for. Right?
Thank you.
You are so beautiful. I'll see you in a minute.
Thank you, God.
Thank you.
John.
No, I can't.
John, John, please don't leave me.
Marie. Marie, I love you. Can you ever forgive me? Then you won't leave me?
No. I'm your wife. I love you.
I'll make you so happy.
Mama, please. Stop asking me those kinds of questions. I love you too.
I can't say that I'm thrilled, John, but what can I do?
Henry, you've had it for 5 years. Now it's my turn. You'll find yourself a new secretary in no time.
Damn it, I do not appreciate your calling. The least Marie could have done is told me herself.
Henry, please.
Damn it, man, I've been good to that girl. I deserve more.
Betty! I'm home.
I've missed you. Be back in a minute. I have to get my luggage.
John?
Yes, my love?
I have to talk to you.
Of course.
I was in the library. I'm sorry.
Forbidden fruit, is that it?
Oh, John, please don't say that. I'm ashamed enough as it is. I saw pictures of a child.
That was me.
And of a woman, a very beautiful woman.
My mother.
Those articles. The one about your father. And the one about Sister Mary. I don't understand. How did she die?
Killed herself?
Oh. Why? Why did she do it?
I don't know.
Forgive me, please. I love you. I do.
Thank you.
Come on, I'll show you the rest of the house.
Holy Spirit, amen. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners now and at the hour of our death, amen. In the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit, amen.
Sleep well, my love? I was so tired.
I know.
Aren't you going to have any breakfast before you go out?
No, not yet. I think I'll go for a run.
It's freezing out there.
Don't worry. I'm a trooper.
Beautiful, isn't it?
Yes, very.
I have some work I'd like to do. Will you call me when dinner's ready?
Mitchell.
That's strange.
What happened?
I don't know. Must be the generator. That's even better. More wine, my love? Good morning, Murray.
John?
you going?
Downstairs. I'm hungry. I want to leave.
Yeah?
Yes, I want to go back.
Don't you like it here?
This can't go on. I thought we could work things out with each other. I believed you when you promised me. You did promise me, didn't you? Well?
You want to leave me? You don't just want to leave. You want to leave me?
Yes.
You are my wife, remember?
That doesn't give you the right to hurt
me. I said you are my wife! You're supposed to love me.
John, I hate you. I'm sorry.
Shut up.
I won't stay with you. I can't. I'm going to leave you.
Not going anywhere, Mary. Understand me? You're never gonna leave me again! You're not gonna leave me again! I'll kill you first! You're never gonna leave me again.
Thank you.
Get undressed. For you.
Sure, the children will call as soon as they can. You know Marie wouldn't let us worry. Besides, I know everything's just fine.
Yeah?
Yeah.
Thank you.
Mama! I love you! There was no Sister Mary. My mama. It was her all the time. She dressed like that and did awful things to me. Then she killed herself, leaving me a monster just like her. Forgive me. Marie, please. Forgive me.
God, no.
You loved me, didn't you?
Yes.
Marie.
How's she doing?
I think she'll be all right. She needs to rest.
It's our fault. The whole thing. We should have watched out for her more carefully. I knew there was something wrong with that guy.
Father Thomas is praying for her. He wants to talk to Marie as soon as the doctor says it's all right.
Father Thomas, will you hear my confession?